Hi guys, Coach Rob Bucklett here. Welcome to Kiyoshi Wisdom, Episode 3, Faith, Hope, and Charity. So this was inspired by a song I heard when I was washing the dishes the other day called A Murder Most Foul by Bob Dylan. The lyric went, Dealey Plaza, make a left-hand turn. I'm going to the crossroads, gonna flag a ride. I'm going down to the place where faith, hope, and charity died. I heard that and I was like, man, that's a podcast right there. Bob Dylan's new song is 17 minutes long. It was released last month. It's not just about the assassination of JFK. It's about how an event can take on a meaning all by itself. I mean, this was released in the midst of the coronavirus pandemic against a backdrop of the media's daily flood of lies and insults towards the president, misinformation about numbers, cures, masks, test kits, breathing apparatus. I'll give you the first verse. I'll tie it in. I think you'll see what I saw. It was a dark day in Dallas, November 63, a day that will live in infamy. President Kennedy was a riding high. Good day to be living and a good day to die. Being led to the slaughter like a sacrificial lamb, he said, wait a minute, boys, you know who I am. Of course we do, we know who you are. And then they blew off his head while he sat in the car. Shot down like a dog in broad daylight. It was a matter of timing, and the timing was right. You got unpaid debts and we've come to collect. We're gonna kill you with hatred without any respect. We'll mock you and shock you and put it in your face. We've already got someone here that can take your place. The day they blew out the brains of the king, thousands were watching and no one saw a thing. It happened so quickly, so quick by surprise, right there in front of everyone's eyes. The greatest magic trick ever under the sun, perfectly executed, skillfully done. I heard that. I thought, wow, that's pretty epic. I mean, I heard the American poet Jim Carroll, singer-songwriter, say that day was the day that America lost its innocence. I mean, I think it's also the day that we lost our faith in government, faith in justice, faith in God. I mean, all these things, faith, hope, charity, things that we should be practicing now. We're on this lockdown. We're, you know, food shortages, toilet paper shortages, craziness, right? Everybody's, you know, scared. They're nervous. They've got anxiety. There's depression. To inspire hope, you've got to base your discussions on reliable evidence. During this time, we're home with our families. Your kids are scared. They've got anxiety, you know? I mean, they don't get to see their friends. They're not doing what they normally do. So you're going to have the talk, you know? And you got to remember, discussions about suffering and illness and disease, they have a negative psychological impact. You got to communicate in a way that's more nurturing towards, you know, your family and your neighbor or whoever it is that you're having the discussion with. Inspire hope rather than fear. You know, if you're feeling loss, a loss of faith, hope, or confidence, practice mindfulness exercises. Concentrate on the breath. Put yourself in a spot. I know it's tough because you're homeschooling now, but put yourself in your comfy chair away from everybody and give yourself a minute, 2 minutes, 3 minutes, and you know, try to restore and enhance you. You know, and be mindful of the idea that these people, your family, your community, they depend on you being your best self during this stressful time. I mean, there was a time that people relied on scripture for inspiration. I mean, the scripture says God is sovereign over illness and suffering, and that we serve the one who casts out all fear. And that's 1 John 4:18. What's left? Charity. Charity. So I'm in Walmart and I see the old dude in the aisle leaning up against his cart, all bummed out because there's no toilet paper. Then you see the other lady with 436 roll packs rolling by in her cart like nothing's wrong. This guy just wants to wipe his butt. I mean, stop hoarding the toilet paper, you guys. The coronavirus, it doesn't make you poop. It does not make you poop. Come on, people. Who poops that much? I mean, only if you're an awful cook. I mean, everyone uses an average of a roll a week. A roll a week. That's four rolls a month. That's for you. And then, you know, for the next person, obviously, they got their own. But that's it. That's it. Leave the toilet paper alone. A lot of this stuff's just in your head. The anxiety, the fear, the depression. You have to identify it. Once you do that, you can begin to understand it and then overcome it. And it reminds me of a quote by Mike Murdock that says, when you can conquer what's in your head, you can overcome anything. Wise words right there. And I'll leave you with this. Another lyric from the song. Midway through the song, Dylan says, they mutilated Kennedy's body for science and cut out his brain. Nobody ever found his soul. My words to you on that is, make sure that you feed yours. Exercise daily, walk the dog, get outside, laugh, love, love your family, love yourself. Guys, we can get through this together. I'm telling you. Till next time, always forward.